Well, long time for two things. One, haven't been on YouTube very much, and two, good grief, Mirage Rack. You probably haven't seen this on this channel for about 13 years, believe it or not, since the early days of this channel has the Mirage Rack made its appearance. However, what we're here today to look at is the range that you can get out of the Ensoniq Mirage. Now, this is the second sampler that I've ever bought. And after the EPS 16 Plus, I just was hearing about and reading about this Mirage thing. I want to know, what's this Mirage? I thought the EPS was the first Ensoniq sampler. Nope, it's this. Today, right now available is update 1.1 of the Ensoniq Mirage Beginner's Manual. So if you have one of these, if you've acquired one and seen one around and wanted one but was afraid of these two digits here, the hex stuff, as you see, it's hex and numeric, but if you're afraid of it, this manual is something that will get you to where you want to go. Now, today we're going to look at the range of the Mirage and what it does to samples that people like. Notably, what's important to note about this sampler is two things. One, it is a 8-bit sampler. So that already right out the gate is kind of important because there's not that many great sounding 8-bit samplers out there. And this is one of them. And two, what an amazing analog filter this thing has. And whenever you take digital and wrap it in analog, you get good stuff. You know, those two play together real nice. Digital oscillator, analog filter, gold. So just what I like to do with this thing is just pitch stuff down and just see how samples stretch out. But we'll do a couple things. We're going to play around with a couple snares and a sample, and we'll see how the Mirage really interprets them and what happens as you go down. I love doing this with the Mirage because it always brings out nice stuff. Anyway, let's listen to the source sound of our snare, which is this. And now let's just play around with the Mirage. So I'm playing it from a keyboard, a little Arteria thing right across from me right now. So we're just going to, let's play, all right? And then what I'll do is I'll go down in pitch like really, really, really low so that we're literally stretching out the samples. And you could just hear how this thing interprets samples, right? So here's the Mirage. Right. Once again, let's take a listen to the original and Mirage. Real good stuff. All right. So let's just let's pitch down. We're getting there. But one thing we can do to get even worse is to go to this value here and really get down on the pitch. So check out. I'm just going to let's go right now. All right. Check this out. Crazy already. You hear how it stretches it out. Let's go even further. So what you'll notice that your simple snare turns into a kick real fast. Gets really, really heavy. Let's see if we can go even further. Oh, we can. All right, let's see what we get now. My gosh. What you're hearing there, that is called stretching out the samples as it just sort of grinds along. You're literally hearing like close to the samples, literally, I mean, not literally, but you're hearing the sample stretch out so much that you're hearing all kind of details. Wonderful stuff to resample and use. This is the low end is just beautiful. Anyway, let's go. Oh my gosh. Great stuff. Let's get back to normal, wherever that is. There we are. Now, what we can do, let's go to another program here and see how the filter reacts, how the resonance and the filter reacts. Isn't that nice? Beautiful. There's our original. So that is just the variety that you can get out of this thing. Yes, it's old, but where it shines, it has a good amount of impressive synthesis, not to mention. But the simple things, the way that it handles pitch range and, you know, when you add the filter to that, there's so many things you can get out of it. So simple way of going about this for creative purposes, you could take anything. And once you start dropping down the sample rate, you'll start to get, the pitch, you will start to get other qualities that you can then use. You saw like right away, started out as a snare and you immediately, you know, by pitching down, you can get some content that really ends up sounding like a kick and the bottom is there. Anyhow, enough of that. Next sample, it's on the upper. Let's see. Let me see if I can get there. Too high. All right, so our sample is going to be a sort of a side stick. So let's take a listen to the original. And now let's take a listen to Le Mirage. Original. Mirage. Isn't it beautiful? So let's, same thing. I'll just play it a little bit and we'll pitch down and see where we get. Oh my goodness. See, you hear that, like, just from those two things already, you can hear it snap a little bit. Watch. Original. Different, as you pitch down, different frequencies get accentuated and it really starts to impact on our perception of how hard something is hitting. Just because the resonant peak of the natural sample starts to jump out as you pitch down at different points that resonate more with us. And thus you could interpret that as something smacking more. Just by pitching it down, you control the energy or skew the energy of the sample. Anyway, enough of that. Pitching down. All right, now let's get really aggressive. Here we go. Ooh, grains. Grains. Super grains. All right, let's go down more. Beautiful stuff. Holy, you may be saying like, yeah, so what? Check this out. If I were to edit, let me just grab that camera. Right? You could get a kick just like that. Let me go back to where I was. Simple kick, but good stuff. Just the quality of the low end is just beautiful. Anyway, back to where we were. There. Let me go 67 lower. Oh gosh. Oh. Right? The way it just sort of drags out this, you get some really grindy stuff. Now, if you're a drone artist, if you just want something to hold, to drone on or to drag out that you could shape again. Check this out. There we go. And you can see that even though it's low res, but yet the Mirage never gets harsh where it tears your ears off. And that's, the filter is unengaged on this, but it's just really, really nice the way it handles stuff and doesn't get harsh as you go down, even when stuff is really brutally digital. Anywho, let me go back and then we're going to listen to a sample. All right, stand by. All right, so we're back with a sample that I'm sure you're familiar with, and we're just going to play it so you can hear it, and then we'll just get to playing around with, one, the range, but two, maybe we'll get the filter involved with this one. Just stand by. Here's the original. And here's the sample. Right, So of course you know that, right? Now let's just pitch down. Let's just really start to right away get aggressive. Hello. Check, you know what I mean? It just switches up right away. Okay, well, let's get the filter and VIX just with this preset here. And what if I delay that time a little bit so that it rises up? Maybe you. And then you, I'll extend. Oh yeah, let's extend you. That's the problem. Let's go to 40, bring you back down. Yes. Let's bring you just a little bit in there. And then bring you down. There we go. Take your time, though. Take your time. Take your time. Right. And then let's go a little bit further, but then let's stretch you down more. Drone-y stuff. Let's get back up to reality. It's so nice to play around with this. Oh boy. So you see what I mean? Like, there's so much range you can get out of these samplers that are apparently on the surface simple. And the trick to it is the sheer quality of it. Due to its age, like this type of thing, you don't really hear in modern samplers just because it's very rarely. I mean, there's new samplers that are coming out now that have analog filters with digital, but not not this type of digital, definitely not 8-bit stuff. And when you have both of these things living in one space, it's absolutely fun to get range. So just a simple pitch, filter, and just playing around, you can get many things. And then when you get them, you just kind of isolate them and you could play them and it will sound oftentimes nothing like what you first put in there. And I say that all to say that many times it doesn't matter what you put in the Mirage, you kind of end up, you know, getting good stuff out of it. And clearly not what you intended to get, but it's usable stuff, like I would say 80% of the time. So that is the Mirage and its range and its fun that you can have with it. If you have one of these lying around and you're just afraid to touch it, you're afraid, the Ensoniq Mirage Manual is for you. We are now on update 1.1. Get yourself sorted with it. Anywho, oh, well, of course, you can get it all at thedaydreamsound.com. Definitely take yourself down there. If you have not signed up to the mailing list, please do so. But that is it for the Mirage. I'm happy to have the rack in. It was sick for a little bit. It's better now to an extent, and it's here. And just really sort of putting it through its paces. I will catch you on the next one. In the meantime, please do take care of yourself. Peace.